The last thing Marion Christensen's family expected from here was to seek a career in the livestock industry. But after graduating college, she found herself working with a company that was making cutting-edge advancement in hog production.
It was called the Eastern North Carolina method of production. It was total confinement, tunnel ventilation, production that was very, very efficient. And it was in that capacity that I met Bob and his group, who came from Minnesota to see what we were doing.
Bob Christensen raised pigs and had come to get her company's opinion on his design to take their containment method to the Midwest. Making the necessary alterations work required a lot of back and forth between Bob and Marianne.
He would send me his information. I would be too busy at work. I'd say, call me after hours, and I'll take your data home with me. We had built up this friendship, and then it gradually turned into something else.
They soon married, and Marianne continued operating a production data company, getting to watch Bob and Christensen's farms grow into her biggest client.
Bob's foundation was always in production. It was always about how do you get the best for and out of your animals, because it was that love of efficiency, caring, that carried through with everything he did.
For Bob, success wasn't measured simply in profits, but also in the quality of life for his animals and the people who made up his local community.
And one of his biggest fears was growing a business that was not of value to people around him and the communities. It is the reward for us to know that we're making a difference in small town USA.
Even as the company grew, Bob felt it was important to make sure new employees, especially in positions of leadership, understood and shared that passion.
I remember part of the interviewing process was taking a drive in his truck around the countryside. It was his way to test people's real interest and intrigue and interest and curiosity of the business and so forth.
The business was at an all-time high and growing every day when the unthinkable happened. On a Saturday morning, Bob Christensen passed away suddenly and without warning.
My kids were first, of course, in my mind, but immediately second was we had to contain any collateral damage to the word spreading of his death, that we were a unified front, that the business would continue because of the commitment to the big picture.
We couldn't wait till Monday. We had to mobilize that day because we knew that we had employees, we had customers, we had contract growers that we deal with, we had communities and so forth that probably thought this would crumble perhaps, or what will happen.
By Monday, the company named their CFO, Glenn Stolt, as the interim CEO, and production didn't miss a beat, which is perhaps the greatest testament to the company Bob had built around him. Today, Christensen Farms is stronger than ever and a key contributor in the global pork industry.
I would describe us as an integrated pork production company that has a presence from the farm to the fork. We are integrated down into kind of some of the elements of pork production, such as genetics and nutrition and feed milling, logistics. We are also integrated going beyond the simple raising of a pig up into primary processing and further processing. While the industry, by and large part, exports about 20, 22, 23, 24% of its product, we currently, through our processing, export about 30% of our product.
But being successful in the pork industry is about a lot more than just making bacon. Christensen Farms takes great pride in the safety of their product.
We are often viewed as less transparent and less regulated. Neither of them are true. I mean, ultimately, the consumer that is consuming our product, whether it's somebody in Japan or somebody in Los Angeles or anywhere in between, it is important to us, and we are highly motivated that that product is as safe as it possibly can be.
In addition to safety, Christensen is always striving to make our environment better, as well as being among the first to implement a program to utilize their waste as a natural fertilizer.
Our pigs eat the corn that farmers that we work with and buy corn from. They obviously dispose of that corn in the form of manure. That manure then is applied to farmland in an environmentally safe process and ultimately eliminates or reduces, not only in economics, but also in unnatural fertilizers, if you will, into that ground. And so that circle happens every year.
In early 2013, Christensen Farms made Glenn's position as CEO official. And you might argue, the company's unconventional path is part of what has made them so successful.
I never aspired to be a CEO. If you compare me against a pool of CEOs in companies of our size, I think I might look like a sore thumb at times. But I also think that with the rest of the team, I think that combination is what's made us successful as well.